electronic flight bags have saved so many hours in flight planning at home, which is where I use mine mostly for. As soon as you open the app, you can pinpoint your intended waypoints. I often do plans over 6,000 miles going around the country, and I can instantly see right there in my waypoints, there's my tracks, I can see terrain, I can see airspace, and I can see most of all distances. So the flight planning capability of these EFBs are the star. They make planning such an easy thing, and they give you options too. Okay, the weather up in Coonabarra Brand's going to be terrible tomorrow. What about if we go via Dubbo? Whatever it is, you can work out logistics really, really quickly, and you know that it's accurate. As light aircraft pilots, we're often not afforded the luxury of carrying a lot of weight. So within the weight of an iPad, you've suddenly got access to a complete library of CASA and Air Services documents that are completely approved. So to have that in iPad format, slip it into your nav bag, super convenient, and weight-wise, it's an absolute bonus. When we're flying, if you are using your paper map with your 10-mile markers or whatever it is that you're using on your map, and say you're doing a cross-country flight and you 1 in 60s don't look like they might be up to scratch, then that's a really great example of when you can pull your EFB out and see what your position is. It builds a lot of confidence in that if you were fearful of getting lost, it gives you an indication that, yeah, you're on the right track. As long as you remember that there is a slight lag in the EFBs, and so your position on the map might not be exactly where you are, it takes a while to catch up. So not to be relied on for instant position fixing, but it's certainly reliable for situational awareness and backs up what you're doing on the paper map in front of you. I use the map option a fair bit, so to flick, for example, onto the IRC chart to see PRD areas, and flick onto the PCA, the planning chart, which brings up my SIGMETs. For me, they're real safety issues, and they're much more convenient than having to unfold yet another map. But if you can view the chart on the EFB, magic. I actually never leave home without my paper charts. If you're following your magenta line when you're using the EFB in the cockpit, I don't feel like you're getting the situational awareness like you would if you were following a map and looking outside. You know, if you've physically drawn your route on a chart, you can't help but to have seen the terrain that you're flying over, your proximity to airspace, that sort of thing. If you're following a line that's continually being corrected by technology, you kind of lose something in translation there. I don't feel like you're quite up to speed with what's going on. EFBs are definitely a positive for aviation safety as long as users know their limitations. The safety is negated when you rely solely on the product as a navigation aid. These EFBs are not approved for sole navigation. The rules that pilots need to be aware of there in PAP 233.1, and I think everybody that uses an EFB needs to have a really good read through that, so that they're familiar with rules about stowage and minimum size, redundancy, that sort of thing. There's a lot to read up on. There are rules about where you can mount your iPad in the cockpit. That all needs reading. Certainly everything has to be stowed, if not mounted, for takeoff and landing.